Hey everyone, my name is Shelby Hartman. I'm Double Blind's co-founder and editor-in-chief, and today we're talking shroom types. But before we do, I just want to remind you to subscribe and turn on your notifications if you never want to miss a video from us. So if you're anything like I was in college, then in the past, you probably haven't asked what type of shrooms that you were getting, because shrooms were shrooms were shrooms. I could tell you, at least for myself, that when I was a freshman in college, I first heard of shrooms from some friends, and they were like, "Do you want a trip?" And I was like, "Sure, what's that?" And my friend just, you know, literally bought some shrooms from some guy in our dorm room at college, right? And we just took them. And I literally just had no idea that there was more than one type of shroom. I mean, I continued to trip once or twice a year all throughout college, and I never knew that there were different kinds of shrooms. Like, I thought there was just one kind. And so I think a lot of people don't, and a lot of people also don't ask, know to ask, before they have a psychedelic experience. But there is so much to learn about the fascinating psilocybin mushroom kingdom, and we're gonna get into some of that today. So believe it or not, there are actually 14,000 different species of mushrooms. That's crazy, right? And more than 180 different species of mushrooms containing psilocybin, which is the primary psychoactive ingredient in what's often referred to as shrooms. Some species also have dozens of different strains with their own signature shape, flavor, and trip. You may or may not know this, but the most popular species of psilocybin-containing mushrooms is
Psilocybe cubensis.
Psilocybe cubensis. To Alex in the back. This is largely because they are easy to cultivate at home. And within the species of Psilocybe cubensis, also at times referred to as cubes or gold caps, because of their golden caps, there are strains such as B+, Penis Envy, and Golden Teachers. We have made videos about these specific strains if you want to learn more about them. However, as Double Blind mycology teacher Dr. K. Mandrake has written for Double Blind, it's really important to distinguish between distinct strains and marketing, because growers sometimes attempt to create new strains, but a strain only exists if it can be reproduced consistently with the same characteristics. So I'm just gonna say that a lot of the hoo-ha that was happening in the early days of cannabis is also happening in shrooms, and a lot of people are like, "Oh my God, you gotta try this strain, you gotta da da da." It's like, some of it's real, some of it's not real. Be critical, folks. In addition to Psilocybe cubensis, some well-known species of magic mushrooms include Psilocybe semilanciata, aka Liberty Caps, Psilocybe azurensis, famous for being one of the most potent shrooms in the world, and Copelandia cyanescens, aka Paniolesis cyanescens, sometimes referred to as blue meanies. Psilocybe sarulescens are famous for being the shrooms consumed and served ceremonially by legendary curandera Maria Sabina. And Sabina, for those of you who don't know, is largely credited for introducing magic mushrooms to the Western world. A famed mycologist and banker named R. Gordon Wasson went down there in the 50s and did mushrooms with her, and then came back and wrote about it for Life magazine in 1957. And that's basically how the Western world came to know about shrooms. And we actually have a whole library of articles on different strains of psilocybin-containing mushrooms written by mycologists Dr. K. Mandrake, Virginia Hayes, Kane Barlow, and others. And what I'm gonna say first and foremost about shroom types before we get more deep into it is that it's just hard to find reliable information about the origin stories of different psilocybin-containing mushrooms, and there is a lot of disagreement about it on boards like Shroomery. So we put a lot of care into our articles, and I encourage you to visit our website and poke around to read about the different types if you want to dive deeper. But let's get into some of what we do know now. Okay, so first up, as mentioned, the most common psilocybin-containing mushroom is the species Psilocybe cubensis. So let's talk about it. If you've eaten psilocybin mushrooms but had no idea what species it was, chances are it was a strain of Psilocybe cubensis. And that's because, as mentioned before, they're the easiest magic mushroom to cultivate at home. And since the 70s, there have been a few pivotal books teaching hobby growers how to do so, including, you might have heard of it, but Terrence and Dennis McKenna's Psilocybin, The Magic Mushroom Grower's Guide. And due to decades of selective home breeding, there are now 60 different strains of Psilocybe cubensis at least, like Golden Teachers, B+, Penis Envy Mushrooms, and Pink Buffalo. In our mushroom growing course, where we've actually taught thousands of people how to grow mushrooms at home, we do typically recommend that people start out with a strain that is easier, right? Some strains are more resistant to mold and other common growing mishaps than others. So while different strains of cubensis can be found in the wild all over the world, the indoor grown types are typically more potent. And that's one of the reasons that mushrooms you buy on the underground market are often stronger than the ones that you're gonna pick in nature, since they've been bred for strength and are grown in specific substrates, which is the material in which you grow mushrooms that increase potency. So let's talk a little bit more about some of the strains of Psilocybe cubensis. Shroom spores are actually available for purchase in Canada and in the United States, except Georgia, California, and Idaho. And that may soon change with California. So you can order them online and they will be shipped directly to your home and everything. And yes, you can grow them, but once you do so, you're technically breaking federal law. So if you go on these sites, some of the spores you'll see are Pink Buffalo, Albino Goldies, B+, Golden Teachers, Stargazer, and Penis Envy. And we can't get into all of these in this video, but let's talk about a few. Pink Buffalo was named by ethnomycologist John Allen on the Leshtai Island of Koh Samui because it was first spotted next to, you guessed it, a pink buffalo. It's on par with other strains of cubensis from Southeast Asia in terms of size and potency. And when it comes to its appearance, pink buffalo boasts large broad caps that can have reddish coloration near the center. And it remains a popular strain for home cultivators because it colonizes quickly and fruits abundantly if conditions are right. Albino Goldies is a strain that was created by crossing the popular strains Golden Teachers and Albino A+. And the result is a beautiful mushroom that showcases the best of its parents in both its appearance and trip. Compared to other cubensis, it's a large mushroom with a long stem and a picturesque golden cap. It's said to be a good mushroom for beginner home cultivators and fruits generously. Albino Goldies are also said to be strong shrooms that combine the smooth, introspective Golden Teacher journey with the very potent intensity of Albino A+, making for a quick come up and deep experience in both the body and mind. I'm gonna put a disclaimer on here though and say that there actually isn't very much known at all about the different ways that different strains and species of shrooms make you feel. So again, be critical because where you're at in your life, where you're tripping, all those sort of tripping fundamentals about how to prepare for a psychedelic journey is going to influence how the journey unfolds just as much, if not more, than the particular strain or species that you choose. B+ is famous for being recommended to first-time growers because it's a resilient strain that can survive a wide margin of growing conditions and some rookie errors while still producing decent fruiting bodies. It's also recommended to first-time journeyers because of its, again, relatively smooth experience akin to Golden Teachers. But again, disclaimer, there actually isn't very much known about the way that these different species and strains feel, and that's something that we gotta learn through research. As mentioned, there's many, many different strains of Psilocybe cubensis. We have a video on Golden Teachers. We have a video on Penis Envy because those are two of the most popular strains. I encourage you to go check them out on our channel. But now let's get into other species of psilocybin-containing mushrooms. Psilocybe semilanciata or Liberty Caps. Psilocybe semilanciata, also known as Liberty Caps, are considered the most widespread naturally growing psilocybin mushroom in the world, according to Psilopedia. And not only that, but they're also the third most potent, according to tests done in 1997 by Paul Stamets and Jochen Gartz, a German chemist and mycologist. Although they grow all over the world, they're very difficult to cultivate indoors, so most Liberty Caps that are consumed are picked in the wild. But be careful. when identifying because they can easily be confused with a few similar looking poisonous species that grow in the same areas. And in general, if you didn't know, be very careful when foraging for mushrooms because there are a lot of dangerous and sometimes even fatal lookalikes. We've done a foraging workshop with mycologist Kane Barlow, who is also a teacher in our mushroom growing courses. And in general, if you didn't know, we do all kinds of workshops at Double Blind, from workshops on microdosing to workshops on trip sitting and holding space for other people. And all of the proceeds from those classes go back to making videos like this possible. We began as a print magazine in 2019. It's still our baby. Where is it? Here it is. and it's just, you know, I'm biased, but beautiful photography and illustration, and we put a lot of care into this. And how we make this possible is, yeah, through the classes, which can be accessed through a monthly membership program that we have, which will also give you access to me and other experts and our community. So if that's something that appeals to you, then you can check out the link in the description of this video. Another popular psilocybin species is Psilocybe azurescens. Psilocybe azurescens are often referred to by a variety of names, including Azies, Astoriensis, Flying Saucers, Blue Runners, Blue Angels, or Indigo psilocybe. And as the story goes, they were first found in 1979 by a group of Boy Scouts camping close to the mouth of the Columbia River in Oregon. Some commentators assume they were probably known before this time, with local foragers referring to them as Psilocybe astoriensis or Psilocybe cyanescens var, standing for variety. In 1995, they were named by Paul Stamets, who we've had for a workshop at Double Blind, and Jochen Gartz as Psilocybe azurescens, which was after Stamets' son Azurius, who had in turn been named after azur, the color that psilocybin mushrooms bruise when damaged. No one can say the guy doesn't love mushrooms. Taxonomically, Psilocybe azurescens are described as having a dark caramel-colored cap that is 3 to 10 centimeters broad, conic to convex in shape, and flattening with age, with a persistent broad umbo. The surface of the cap is smooth, with a viscous appearance when moist, feeling sticky to the touch, with a separable gelatinous pellicle that can be removed if the cap is broken carefully. One thing we'll note about Psilocybe azurescens is that these babies are strong, typically a lot stronger than Psilocybe cubensis. 1 dried gram is typically the minimum amount needed to trip for a species like Psilocybe cubensis, but with Psilocybe azurescens, even 1 gram could be a strong dose. So psychonauts, be cautious. What about other magic mushroom species? Well, as mentioned, there are more than 180 different psilocybin-containing mushrooms. So we're obviously not gonna get to them all in this video, but we are doing our very best to build out an encyclopedia of reliable guides written by mycologists on psilocybin species and strains on the Double Blind website. And we're just working as fast as we can to put these guides together, and we're really proud of them. So check them out there. Some other psilocybin containing mushrooms you might have encountered are Psilocybe tampinescens, which are magic truffles or philosopher's stone. These are the types of psilocybin mushrooms that are sold at specialty shops and given at magic truffle retreats in the Netherlands through a legal loophole. There's also Psilocybe zabotecorum, another species native to Mexico that has current and likely ancient ceremonial use. It's named for the Zapotec indigenous community of southern Oaxaca, and according to Gaston Guzman, is thought to be the mushroom in many of the ancient ceramic mushroom statues that have been uncovered in Mexico. There's also Psilocybe cyanescens, or wavy caps, because of the wavy cap that the mushroom has, a sort of a ripple shape to its cap. And they're believed to be native to Central Europe and the Pacific Northwest, but it's hard to tell because they are now one of the most widespread wild psilocybin-containing mushrooms in the world. And there's Copelandia cyanescens, or Paniolesis cyanescens, sometimes referred to as blue meanies, which can be confusing because there is also a strain of Psilocybe cubensis called blue meanies. There are also tons of lesser known psychedelic mushroom types, such as psilocybe subarugonosa, which is famous in Australia, actually, for its potency, enigma mushrooms, a mutant form of the popular psychedelic psilocybe cubensis, which recently had a viral moment on our Instagram because they just look so weird, and there's obscure strains such as Pluteus americanus, which basically no one has heard of and is a psychedelic mushroom first collected by a mycologist in Michigan in 1957. So are there magic mushrooms that don't contain psilocybin? Well, in addition to psilocybin-containing mushrooms, you've probably heard of Amanita muscaria, which is the mushroom that grows in Siberia, which is often associated, probably incorrectly, with the origin story of Santa Claus. It's the mushroom in Super Mario, it's the mushroom emoji on your phone with the red cap and the white dots, and it's actually legal in the United States, but we wouldn't necessarily recommend tripping on it. You know, we have a whole guide and articles on, you know, journeying on Amanita muscaria, and we did a workshop on it, but we'll just say, generally speaking, that a lot of people report that large doses of Amanita muscaria is not a pleasant experience, but one of the compounds in it, Musimol, has actually shown promise for anxiety at small doses. The point is, there's a lot to know about shroom types, where they grow naturally, if they do at all, how they were discovered, how to recognize them when foraging, and what kind of trip they might give you. But I'm just gonna remind people that there actually isn't very much known at all about the difference in their effects. And there's a different combination of compounds and alkaloids in all of these mushrooms. And a lot of experts hypothesize that they probably work synergistically together to create what we sometimes refer to in cannabis as the entourage effect, right? And it's this idea that everything in the mushroom works together to create the effect that it gives you. And all the research that we're looking at now that's showing psilocybin has promise for substance dependence, depression, etc., is just looking at synthetic psilocybin, one compound. But the trip, when you're tripping on a whole psilocybin mushroom grown in a house or grown from the earth, is, you know, much more complex. So, as mentioned, we've devoted a lot of care into working with the most brilliant minds we know to uncover what we do know about the fascinating world of shroom types, but there's a lot more to know. Are you interested in learning more or have questions about a particular shroom? We'd love your help in building out our shroom type database. Let us know in the comments of this video or DM us on Instagram if you've had experiences with a particular mushroom that you'd like to see us explore. And that's all for now. Until next time. We'll be right back.